Are you looking for the ultimate guide for assigning tasks and responsibilities within a software development team? You're in luck, because today we're going to discuss the Rational Unified process and teach you more about this framework, which can help teams develop high-quality software. So, what is RUP? Let's find out. RUP was initially developed by Rational Software Corporation, which was acquired by IBM in 2003. Since then, RUP has been used extensively for big software development projects. But there are also plenty of examples when small projects of limited scope and resources have greatly benefited from using it. One example is the TAP, or Technology as Promised, online management system, which implemented RUP to extend face-to-face training. RUP allowed TAP to boost its online offer for corporate and public customers, as well as students. RUP provided guidance and remarkable results that helped in building the necessary framework. So, let's take a closer look at how you can implement RUP in 6 steps. Develop software iteratively. RUP projects should grow through multiple iterations, and the quality of the delivered projects should increase with each iteration. For a functional and operable release, each activity or process has to meet the evaluation criteria. Manage requirements. RUP gives you an in-depth insight into the project's requirements and makes them easier to manage. Having all the info about the requirements of any project will help you make the right decisions, order your project documents, and establish functionality requirements. Use component-based architecture. Since the architecture is based on components, developers will be more flexible in working on additional features across different projects. The reusable components make the software less variable and reduce the number of dependencies between code and modules. Visually model software. With RUP, the team builds software by following visual models or diagrams. You can use object diagrams, activity diagrams, and sequence diagrams to help the team make progress. Verify software quality. The software produced is regularly checked for quality, so the defects are spotted early in production and promptly fixed. Verifying software quality ensures that you deliver a top-notch product that meets users' needs. Control changes to software. Finally, RUP is a very useful framework if you want to track, monitor, and control even the slightest of changes in the production process. This applies to all aspects of the project. Code, production, system tests, iteration plans, you name it. Monitoring changes gives you enough info to make the right decisions, create a secure workspace, and bring the team together. The foundations of RUP are the who, how, what, and when. Let's take a closer look at these. The who. Workers. The behavior and responsibility of all team members are defined, together with how the work should be carried out. Everyone works on producing artifacts, and team members also own the set of artifacts they make. The how. Activities. Each activity is a work unit with a clear purpose that is assigned to a specific worker. Activities include creating or updating any of the artifacts. The what. Artifacts. These are products of the process that can be modified or used as the team works towards the outcome. An artifact can be an input or an output of the activity performed. The when. Workflows. A workflow is a sequence of activities that produce value. The workflow can be presented as a diagram, whether it's a sequence, collaboration, or activity diagram. The life cycle of RUP consists of 4 phases. Inception, elaboration, construction, and transition. The most important project milestones are the goals achieved at the end of each phase. The team then confirms that these goals have been achieved. At this point, the team makes critical decisions that will affect the next stage. The inception phase focuses on the basic structure and idea of the project. After considering estimated costs and the required resources, the team looks at the project's goal and decides whether it is worth pursuing. In the elaboration phase, the project plan is developed. This is the most critical stage, during which the team decides whether or not to start coding. This phase aims to eliminate the highest risk elements by analyzing all the requirements and the system's architecture. Once the team is fully equipped, it's time to start developing and integrating the features into the product in the construction phase. During this stage, the focus is on both developing components and managing resources, quality, cost optimization, and schedules. Finally, the moment the product is finished and released to end users marks the beginning of the transition phase. The product is delivered to users, after which problems and bugs are fixed in response to user feedback. So, should you use RUP in your business? Unfortunately, RUP is difficult to implement for small businesses, teams, and projects. However, if you're working on a large software development project that faces constant changes in requirements and needs accurate written documentation, RUP is the framework for you. And if you still need to find the right project management tool, make sure you check out ActiveCollab. We hope you've enjoyed this video. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to our channel where you can check out heaps of other videos. Bye for now, and thanks for watching. One example is the tap. Technology is... During this...